When you hear about autism and obsessive compulsive disorder known as OCD, you might think these two conditions are very different from each other. However, did you know people with autism are twice as likely to receive a diagnosis of OCD, and people with OCD are four times as likely to also have autism? In today's video, we'll be covering the topic of autism and OCD and how to spot the differences between the two. But before we do that, please take a minute, subscribe to my channel, and click the little bell to receive notification when I post a new video. Hi, welcome to my little space right here on YouTube. I'm Maria Ward, and if this is your first time on my channel, I'm an author, motivational speaker, and mom of three fantastic autistic children. And this channel is all about sharing with you tips and strategies that can empower you as a parent so you can help your autistic child reach their maximum potential. And one of the ways we can help them achieve this is by understanding other conditions. One of the most common things in autism is what we call comorbid conditions. In other words, the presence of one or more additional conditions along with autism spectrum disorder. One of those conditions is obsessive compulsive disorder. OCD is an anxiety condition that causes repeated unwanted thoughts, which are the obsessions, and along with it, the urge to do something or perform a particular ritual, which is the compulsion, in order to alleviate anxiety. Even though in both conditions people perform rituals or self-soothing behavior, people with OCD in a social situation will be embarrassed by having to perform certain actions, while the person on the autism spectrum will not necessarily be bothered by how they are perceived, or in other cases, they might not even be aware of this behavior. Another difference is that people with OCD describe their obsessive thoughts as unwanted because it results in a great deal of anxiety and distress, causing them to have to engage in ritualistic behavior in order to appease their anxiety. On the other hand, people who are on the autism spectrum do not seem to experience that same level of anxiety from their obsessive topics of interest. It's more, and I'm sure you have seen it yourself with your child or other autistic children, they seem to enjoy those areas of interest and talk for hours about all the knowledge they have accumulated. Also, people with autism engage in several kinds of ritualistic or self-soothing behavior, but instead, people with OCD cannot substitute their particular obsession and consequently compulsion by choosing another type of ritual. They usually have to do something in a certain way, at a certain time, in order for them to be satisfied. In addition, obsessive behavior in OCD can be very disruptive to a person's life, to the point where those obsessions become their whole life, while in autism it is not the case. So yes, even though there are clear similarities between OCD and autism, in many cases someone can have both. The reason behind the compulsive behavior in each one of these conditions is completely different, and the key factor to understand the difference between the two. I hope this short video can give you something to think about if you were wondering about the differences between OCD and autism. Thank you so much for watching and subscribing. Don't be shy, and please leave a comment in the section below and let me know what your experience has been like with regards to OCD. And if you would like to see more videos, I hope you enjoy these.